So having injections into the eye for any disease, AMD, as well as diabetes, can be a really daunting process for my patients. And myself and my team try to take the anxiety out of this. And it really starts with education first. So what we do is spend some time with patients explaining, particularly for conditions like AMD and diabetes, that there might be more injections to start off with than fewer. And there might also be some instances that these injections are lifelong. And it's important to sort of set this at the start so patients do understand that it's important that they return for their follow-up injections. The other thing that's important is to realise that we're trying to maintain vision here. If we get an improvement in vision, that's a bonus. But what we're really trying to do is to maintain stable vision and prevent it from deteriorating further. The intravitreal injections are performed in theatre or in our specialised treatment room. They're done under an aseptic technique, and the reason for this is to reduce the risk of any infections that can occur. Patients are generally anaesthetised first, which means that there is some topical anaesthesia, sometimes drops or a gel, so they can't feel the pain of an injection. In fact, all you ever feel is a little bit of pressure. The injection itself takes less than a couple of minutes to perform, and afterwards patients can return back to normal. We advise patients to be really careful though following the injection and then even 24 hours after that. The things that I particularly tell my patients to look out for are changes in their vision, such as shadows or dark spots in their vision. These are abnormal and may mean that there are changes in the retina that we need to look at. So they are aware that they need to see us almost immediately when they notice symptoms like this.